Hello?
You all right, miss? What can I do for you?
Well, first I want a licorice lace, because I haven't seen them in about 10 years. And I used to love them as a kid. And I'm looking for my friend. She moved here about 9 months ago. Do you recognise her?
No, sorry, I'm just kidding. Yeah, this is the girl who moved into the lighthouse. Yeah, she comes in here from time to time. She's not quite this girl anymore.
Well, how do I get to this lighthouse? Maya, right? It's Amy. You've grown. Well, it looks like you've finally learnt how to cook, then. It's a nice place, isn't it? Very distant. Maya's grown.
What do you want?
You, Beth? Jesus. I didn't even get a chance to say goodbye. I had to find out where you were from Charlie in accounts.
How's he doing?
Oh, great. Yeah, he's getting a new puppy.
What kind?
I don't know. What are you doing? God, you're like a 5-year-old.
Why are you here?
I just want to talk to you, Beth. Just one night and then I'll go. We can't leave things how we left them. Anyway, it took me ages to get here. And it looks like you need a little bit of a hand.
You're really good at making it look like I have a choice.
That's what I'm best at.
That's what I meant. In about 2 minutes, your road home will be underwater.
Thanks for helping me with my bag, by the way.
You brought it.
Well, if you've lost your mind out here, at least you've still got your taste in music.
Need something to fill the void. Not now, Maya. Maya, go. What do you want? Jesus, Maya!
She's still not talking.
I tried not to talk about it.
Oh, you've got a dog.
Had.
Oh, sorry. What kind of dog was she? It's a bit dark in here. Shall we open the curtains?
Toad. We like a chat.
Okay. It's a bit weird.
I think I see things all the time. It's probably just drifted, or a whale. Lighthouses are more about people looking this way than us looking out.
Very educational.
In a past life, I used to tell people about things.
How has the advertising game survived without you?
Has it? I have people like you in charge.
Still around. I actually left the company a couple of months ago. I didn't want to keep walking past your old office and making small talk with people. No one said anything, but I wasn't very popular after you left. How's Maya?
She's in the room.
She's amazing, you know. You can always tell that she's thinking. There's a lot going on in there.
Look, I don't really know what I'm doing.
No. Seems like it.
I'm sorry, I should have said something.
Yeah, you should.
Christ, I wasn't going to hang around to explain to everyone how it gets better every day.
So you just moved out here to the arse end of nowhere?
It's definitely a change of pace.
Say that again.
Quiet, at least. No gossip.
So that's it? Just you and Maya? How long? You're not coming back, are you?
You left, didn't you?
Yeah, I don't mean back like that. I mean, you know, people, schools. How is Maya's schooling?
I'm homeschooling her.
What? Beth, come on. Maya needs to be around kids her own age. She's help, professionals, specialists, people who know stuff.
I know stuff. We tried, okay? It didn't work.
So you stopped trying? Sorry.
It's getting late. I should go and make the sofa up. We can chat in the morning.
Thanks for letting me stay.
So, erosion. Hey, Maya? Maya? You paying attention? Good. So you see these cliffs way back here, huh? They used to be all the way out there over thousands of years ago. Before the lighthouse, before us, before anything. Maya. You see the way the waves hit them? Every time they hit, they break off teeny tiny pieces that we can't even see. And the
cliffs become smaller and smaller as the waves knock them off more and more. Amy.
So, what happens to the teeny tiny pieces?
Good question. So the little pieces become sediment at the bottom of the sea, and sometimes they wash up onto the coast and they form beaches. Basically, erosion is when something big breaks down little by little and ends up somewhere else. And Amy, if you're going to try and turn that into a Freudian metaphor, I swear to God, I'm going to slap you.
You said it. When are you going to start teaching Maya something else? I mean, come on, erosion. What about, snow? Shakespeare? Anything.
I thought this would be something nice.
No, you thought that this was going to make you look like you knew what you were doing. Okay, grab that. So, you know what this is? This used to be somebody's house. A crustacean, here you go, that lived in this rock pool. Do you like rock pools? So do I. I love rock pools. I used to play in them all the time. They were so much fun.
Get inside.
What? Why?
Don't toss, just go. Maya, let's go.
What? Beth?
Now!
I had a weird childhood too. You won't tell your mum, will you?
Thanks.
In his house. Hey, Maya. Oh, cool. I used to be really good at drawing. Okay. A bit too soon. That's fine. Just show me when you're ready, yeah? Does that kind of thing happen a lot with your mum? It's weird, because when I met your mum, it was at this marketing conference thing, which is basically just a room full of boring people talking about boring things for a living. But your mum got up on stage because she was doing a talk, and the whole room fell silent because she just had this energy about her. And she made you feel like she was talking to each person individually. And she was up there talking to us about the secret of, I don't know, whatever. And halfway through I realised that I was laughing. And I was the only one laughing. I looked around the room and everyone was looking at me like I was some sort of crazy person. But Beth just carried on. It was like she was trying to make me laugh, but just for me. By the end of it, obviously, she got everyone around and everyone was standing up on their feet and cheering. I was at the back, so I popped out to the loo, and when I walked in, she was in there, but she had her back to me. And I realised that she was just throwing her guts up over the toilet. Just vomiting. Sorry, that was probably a really weird story to tell you, wasn't it? Look, what I'm saying is, your mum is so clever and so controlled, or she likes to think she's in control all the time. She likes people to believe that she's in control. And I think at the moment she's having a bit of a tricky time. I just need your help to look after her. Do you think you can do that? Thanks.
Amy. Where have you been?
What were you doing by the cliff edge? Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yes.
Then what were you doing?
Why were you following me? Crapots.
Look, this place is... I think we should leave.
I'm not going anywhere. You can go if you want.
We can't stay like this.
What are you doing here?
I'm trying to help you.
Why? Go get cleaned up. There's no one else here for miles except you, me, and my daughter.
Where's Maya? This is ridiculous. She can't have gone far, can she?
Lifts, box.
You said it yourself. If the tide comes in and
yeah, but she's never disappeared
here.
Before, has
no.
she?
No.
Maya! Maya! Are you drunk?
Let's just find Maya, okay?
Okay, she hasn't run off before, though.
What are
she...
you getting at?
Well, just that if you're... How can you have one eye on her?
I know how to look after my daughter.
Yes, but after what happened yesterday...
Maya! The only thing that's changed is you.
Beth, come on. What are you not telling me?
Maya! Why did you come down here, Maya? Why? Why? Did you come down here alone? You can't leave me like that, Maya. Why?
I think we should go back and bury it.
Thank you.
Maya! Maya, what's wrong? Oh my God. It's okay. It's just a bad dream. You're gonna be okay.
What's wrong? Is she okay?
She's just having a nightmare.
How often does she wet the bed?
She doesn't.
The good news is we didn't find anything physically wrong with Maya, apart from the rather nasty panic attack, and she's calm now. Due to the severity of the attack and your unusual living situation, I am going to prescribe some emergency medication in the event that you can't get back to us. Of course, we'll have to wait for the test to come back to get the complete picture, but as far as we can tell, she's going to be just fine. A good night's sleep, and someone to keep an eye on her for a few days should suffice. You look like that wouldn't hurt you either.
Maya doesn't talk. She hasn't made a sound since her father died. She doesn't make a sound when she laughs or cries either. I've tried everything to get her to speak. I've taken her to therapists, psychologists, hypnotists, nothing. But last night she screamed at the top of her lungs. It was deafening.
There's no physical reason why Maya shouldn't speak or make any of the noises on the usual scale. Sometimes when a child undergoes trauma at a young age, they can take a little while feeling comfortable communicating, and I think this is on that spectrum.
Do you think she'll start talking now?
Well, there's no overnight cure, but with patience, most cases catch up. You should probably inform her school if they're not already aware. Children like Maya can need a little extra care and attention to stop them falling behind. You may want to consider a specialist learning centre if you're willing and able to move.
I'm homeschooling her. She doesn't do well with large groups of people.
Well, she's still very young, and with the right encouragement, it may be best for her to endure more socialisation, however daunting. I'll bring her through to you in a moment. Oh, whilst it's not the sound you were hoping for, it is a start, wouldn't you agree?
I wonder what she's going to sound like when she starts talking again.
Maybe like you. Silent.
She had a very pretty voice.
Yeah?
Yeah, she used to read out loud all the time. She had a great vocabulary. We used to sing together. I love singing.
Yeah, no, you do.
You do?
Yeah. I used to hear you humming from my desk all the time. But that doctor said that everything's going to be fine, that she's going to be okay.
But you don't think so.
Would you think it was weird if I stayed to find out?
Don't come in until I tell you. Maya, stay with Amy. I'll be back in a moment, okay?
Thank you.
This is where Christian grew up, isn't it?
Did you break in here?
No! This was someone else! Look, what is happening here?
There's no one in the house now. I must have... Let's just forget about all of this.
This! After what he did and you leave his stuff here like a fucking museum!
It is his house!
No, he's dead! And good riddance!
God, look, are we safe here?
Maya. It's all right, Maya. There's nothing to be afraid of. I checked everything. There was nothing.
What are you doing with a knife?
Maya. Maya. Give me the knife. Maya!
Your bed at night.
I think I've seen him too.
This shit again, really?
I finished with her. She knows that.
I didn't even ask you to leave the fucking company because I figured you'd do it for me. For Maya, a little girl?
Christian, I...
Now, how many chances too many, Beth? How many times enough? Because I'm starting to lose count.
I'm sorry, okay? We'll be fine, I promise. Give me one more chance.
planned a surprise for you. I wanted us to celebrate. Is it still worth it?
Of course. Come on. Show me the surprise. This is nice. Thank you. I'm sorry.
No, no, you're not.
I mean it. Please, Christian, just forgive me this one last time, and I promise you this will never happen again.
You make it sound like I have a choice.
You do. You've always got a choice, and I'm just so grateful that you're using that choice to take me back. For Maya.
I've been thinking about this, you know. Did you know that you can predict 87% of US presidential elections just based on height alone? It's called the halo effect.
I know what the halo effect is, Christian. Listen.
No. You can predict 87% of elections because people always assume that tall people are more capable. They think pretty people are kind. We think being good at something means you'll be good to other people. We just see something good and think that more goodness will grow from it. Like good and bad are just on a scale, and if you're enough steps along, the rest will just take care of itself. And that's you, Beth. People convince themselves that you're special, that you're so charming and intelligent that you have to be somewhere deep down a good person. And then we want you to like us. But you're not. You're mean and narcissistic and controlling and a drunk. It's much worse for Maya. And you're so blinding for the rest of us. But for her, you're her mother. People waste their whole lives wanting their parents to love them, and you've already got two of us completely lost. You have probably more. I don't know, I'm guessing.
There isn't anyone else.
You're so convincing. She will sacrifice everything just to be there for you because she thinks you're perfect. But you're not. You just suck people in. And you wouldn't sacrifice shit for anyone, not even her. I can't see it. And I know you.
So what do you want me to do?
Change. You're not going to, are you? I'll probably keep falling for it as well. And what chance does Maya stand with parents like us, eh?
Christian, don't you? Look, I've seen something, someone, I don't know, it's always out of the corner of my eye, but I think Maya's seen it too. Look, I went back and buried that dead dog. Look, you just have to tell me. You have to tell me, because otherwise I'm just gonna take my stuff and take Maya.
No!
We can't stay here. Not like this. If there is something out there, there is something you are not telling me about.
Look what we did. What's wrong? And now we're being punished for it.
Fuck that! Fuck that and fuck you! He tried to kill you, Beth! He pulled you over a cliff into the ocean, and then, what, you drag your daughter out here to his house, which is literally surrounded by cliffs and the ocean. Do you understand how insane that is, Beth? You are the biggest risk out here.
What? Risk to whom?
Okay, maybe there isn't anything like... Maybe I was wrong about the dog, but the first thing that needs to happen is you need to get rid of Christian's stuff. All of it, all gone. Beth, he is dead. You are keeping him alive.
So that's it. You just want me to get... to destroy everything, and then when Maya asks me about her father, I tell her what?
Yes. Or lie. That's not a truth anyone deserves. Look, you have to burn it, Beth. All of it.
I can't.
Yes, you can. You can. This isn't you. You're better than this. You have to.
Will you stay? Please. Fine. Do it.
It has to be you.
Fine. Fine. Do you know what? Why wait? I just saw someone come in here.
Beth.
Maya. Tell me, please just speak to me. Say something, Maya. Please.
Beth.
Maya, what do you have behind your back? Show it to me. You said everything, right?
Beth.
scary sometimes, isn't it? My mum used to be my favourite person in the whole world. She was a nurse and she always knew what to do. And then she got sick herself. She didn't know what to do anymore. And some days I'd get home from school and she'd open the door to me and look at me like I was some sort of stranger. Sometimes she'd just shut the door on my face and little by little I could see the person who I loved the most in the world was going away.
Beth? 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 What? What? What's going on?
Still in there.
Oh my God, here you go again.
Amy. Amy, please, it's me. I'm okay now. Christian's gone. I beat him, you see. We can be together again. Just like before, just you and me. And I... You have to come out eventually. I am here now. Maya, you trust me, don't you? It'll be just the two of us again soon. We're not going anywhere.
This place isn't sick. It's you. Maya, come on. Come on.
Kill you before I let you take her.
Maya!
Hi. Good day at school? Go on then, chatterbox. In you get.
Mom?
Ce matin, quand tu as frappé à ma porte, tôt ce matin, ouh, quand tu as frappé à ma porte, je dis bonjour. bonjour Satan. Je crois qu'il est temps d'y aller. Moi et le diable marchons côté à côté. Moi et le diable marchons côté à côté.